DozhaToldya.com. Might not be coming through today, but it's all good. We still do have plenty to talk about, man, in sports, politics, rap news, and more. So, you know, I'm here to get into it. And I had to kind of like, of course, the music that we were just listening to was Spinner Benz. He's a Duval artist. He's one of my favorite Duval artists. I wonder how that would look if he would do the show from somewhere else. It's kind of messed up. Yeah, man, they on Lizzo ass because she be showing her ass. And, she be showing her ass. And, yeah, there's a lot of shit going on, man. You know. I guess I just kind of played the music. I got throwed off because I was looking at Lizzo's ass. I was actually supposed to be talking about Spinner Benz and how his music is a little too violent that I had to just skip it. But I got caught up looking at Lizzo's ass, literally, and I can't even think. She just had her ass out going on, getting on a plane. And I see somebody with a post about it. And I was like, damn, that's crazy. Like, you know, I guess I kind of want to go back and look at it again. Not that it. Lizzo basically is trying to make a point that even though she's big, she could still do things that smaller women do. Or she could still show her body in certain ways. But it's still like a untasteful way is what she really ought to avoid. But I don't know, man. It's a lot, man. It's a lot of stuff to talk about this week that could get a guy in trouble this week, too. I'll tell y'all that much. Because that boy Cam Newton, boy, they on his ass. Cam Newton said they need to just shut up. Cam Newton said women need to just shut up. Well, he ain't just say that. But women need to know how to know when to shut up and let a man lead, so to speak. And you know the women ain't going for that. Not today's women. They not going for that. They like, oh no, scam. You wildin' scam. Cut that shit out, scam. Don't do them like that, scam. Scam Newton, they called him. My boy pulled off a good one in his day. Pulled off a little good one in this gay old scam. Yeah, he did. So yeah, man, we gotta. I guess I'm gonna kind of go through the topics and pull up parts and pieces, I guess, if you will. So y'all can kind of like, I'll be a little more prepared. I use a lot of this time to prepare and also speak to the people about just like local stuff that's going on. Cause like I said, there's a concert going on tonight, Boys to Men, free concert. I just found out about it, actually. I didn't even know. But now that I do know, it's like, it's a part of me that be wanting to be around stuff like that, and there's a part of me that be like, man, all them people gonna be there? Why can't I just have Boys to Men by themselves, you know what I'm saying? Boys to Men and my friends, you know what I'm saying? Like, I need to be strapped where I could just do that, man, for my friends, man. So I could just get Boys to Men and my friends and not have to deal with parking and scooting around all these black folks. And I ain't talking shit just because it's black folks. No, that ain't. I'm trying to think of it, trying to get the right beat to play. I play that. But yeah, man, I don't know if I'm ready to be around a lot of people still. Like, it's an outdoor concert. It's a jamming by the river, Jack's River Jams or something like that. And it should be monumental. They usually have them like every other Thursday, I think. Not every other Thursday, but once a month on a Thursday, they have a big concert, supposedly during the spring and for the summer, planned. So, you know, that ought to be pretty good. Pretty good experience to have. You know, go to the end of the road with Boys to Men. I had to think about it, right? Go out there unless you're ready to fall in love, son. No, they definitely gonna be out there, though. They definitely gonna be out there. I don't know. RC said he probably should did the show from out there. I don't know how I feel about doing on-location shows. Like, unless I can really have the whole, I'm about to get like a booth built for on-location shows. It's just me and this green screen. I could be anywhere with the green screen though. Get like a little green screen booth built. Yeah, man, but I was just thinking a lot of different things throughout the week, man. A couple of quotes share with my friend that I might want to share with y'all. We have to like get more worth out of our network, right? Like sometimes I think that instead of going for a numbers game, right? Cause yeah, I would like to up the numbers. But we still like past just having a lot of numbers. You want to have people that really just fuck with you. And they're going to stand up, you know, stand up with you or whatever in the paint, man. Loyal, if you will. Loyalty is a motherfucker, man. Can you buy loyalty? That's one question. I need some new questions too. The podcast. Should we have like questions of the day on this podcast? Like I have like top fives or on the other podcast. Man, I've been thinking about booking guests to come in. People can already, I know many people have heard me already say this before, but you can call in and occasionally a few of my friends do call in. But I admit, I kind of ran off some of my friends from calling in. My boy Raj used to call in, and I'd be like, man, I'm calling too early, Raj. He's like, oh, my bad, bro. And I ain't, you know, that bitch ass nigga, I was gonna be one calling. And I ain't say that. I love my brother. My brother is having such a great time with his son, man. Shout out to the kids, man. The kids is what gets you blessing from, man. The kids is what you got your blessing from, man. It's a lot of new movies coming out. And it's a lot of good things on Disney Plus. One of my favorite networks. Nope, this is a shameless plug. But Moon Knight, man. Y'all watch Moon Knight yet? Y'all don't even know about Moon Knight. See? Now it's time for DozhaToldya. Y'all don't even know about Moon Knight. Yeah, man. So, shout out to Snowfall, man. I asked somebody the other day, like, if they had to pick between Snowfall and Power, which one would it be? I'm gonna start asking everybody, like, tough questions like it's on the interview. That's just how I'm gonna do that shit. I'm like, tough questions, you know what I'm saying, to everybody. Just be like, if you had $10 million to donate to get $100 million, who would you give $10 million to? And I'm like, what the fuck? Like, if you was Dwayne Wade and Gabrielle Union, how would you raise? Nah. Start asking everybody tough questions, man. What do you do when you run out of toilet paper? Tough questions for everybody. Nah, bullshit, man. Life is an interview, man. I keep telling y'all, life's a podcast, man. And you know what? Never mind. That's for another date. But yeah, man, it's your boy Dame Doja, DozhaToldya Radio presents the DozhaToldya Podcast. Let me get back into character here, man. Because we got people, man. We got people to entertain. A lot of new music dropped this week. I'm just gonna give a quick intro before my brother RC pulls up. And you know, we can get on with the next show, Keeping It Blunt with Damon RC at 7 o'clock. So I got y'all for like, you know, an hour or two before my boy come up here, man. So, what can I do with this hour or two, man? Of course, like I said, you guys can call in. The number is 904-257-6996. That's 904-257-69 if you're nasty. 96 if you're a 90s baby. My brother was graduating in 96. Actually, he had already graduated by 96. I tell everybody how old he is and not how old I am. Nah, we ain't hiding shit over here, man. We ain't hiding shit over here. But yeah, we was listening to Spinner Benz when we came, brought the show in, and he got a trap country song, a trap drill song. And I thought I would be checking it out, but I had to cut the music halfway through the song because these kids might be taking this drill shit a little too far. Like, so drill music means kill music, from my understanding. But you can't say kill because nobody would like it. So it's drill music, right? And I guess I do like drill music because it's, I mean, I fuck with Lil Durk, G Herbo, you know, is not my favorite. Sometimes I think he be offbeat a lot, but that's the drill thing. Like, they saying that they could be offbeat now because they talking about killing. Like, so since y'all talk about killing somebody, y'all could now be all beat and y'all wreck records, I guess. And I just gotta accept it. Like, they're like, yeah, nigga. Yeah, you got to accept that we don't want to rap on beat no more. Oh, niggas think y'all run hip hop? Nah, nigga. We finna run hip hop straight into the fucking grind. Nah, man, these are just old bad jokes, man. I gotta get my joke button back, man. I can't believe I got... What happened to my joke button, man? These are all bad jokes, man. I'm gonna download my new joke button. Or I might just get my own round of applause and my own laughter button. I'm gonna call my own shots on y'all niggas. We supposed to have a cuss bucket too, right? Did we say we was gonna have a cuss bucket this week? No saying the B word, no saying the N word. In that case, I would have owed some money by now. In that case, I don't know if we ready for that. I don't know if we ready for no cuss bucket yet. We might have to watch out. Fuck around and spend all my money before I even go anywhere. But yeah, man, a lot of folks going out to the show tonight. So you go out there, ladies, have y'all a good time. Come on back to your man. Feel the music, feel the night. But ladies, y'all don't have to drag y'all men out to the Boys to Men concert. Cause after them boys became men, it was like, oh, okay, one of them. So a lot of that music, we don't really even know. Tell you the truth. I was a boy and they took me all the way into a man. I do remember though listening to Boys to Men at house parties. Yeah, I guess I'm about to age the podcast right now, but Iceless is Boys the Man. I guess that's not really aging myself. Everybody go to house parties, right? I act like only us old niggas did house parties. Right now they just do internet room gatherings now. House party? What's a house party? We just get on the Zoom call together. What do you mean? We just FaceTime each other every week. We don't do any house parties. I tell you, boy. These new people, they got the world is your oyster, new people. They trying to go to Mars and beyond, man. You think some old people went out of space, by the fact, got a trip there. I don't know, I'm spaced out. I'm a space cadet right now. I'm kind of all over the place. I went from talking about spinning bands, talking about kill music. But yeah, man, these young guys, I'm all over the place, but my main idea is I was talking about knowing your net worth and network and all kind of shit. La, 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 la. What did I say? All the niggas here, over here, blah, 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 blah. Shout out to Rich on the Quan. But nah, man, these folks is taking this music to somewhere that I don't know. It's like drill music. Purposely rapping off beat. Or they just don't know that they rapping off beat. Then they trying to tell me that maybe I'm tripping. Cause I hit the day off beat. And then, you know, sometimes with the rap, they cover that shit up pretty good, though. You won't really even realize them boys was... I guess that don't matter. Let me stop aging myself. Oh, yeah, and I was also aging myself again with Boys the Men. Tonight at 8 o'clock, man. Shout out to them folks that's going out there. Make sure y'all be safe. Do not fall on bended knee and become brokenhearted. Fuck around with one of them boys or men who never even been to a Motown Philly. That Motown Philly was the shit. But shout out to Teddy Riley, because that Motown Philly wasn't even been out if it wasn't for Teddy Riley. Like, doing a little East Coast swing and New Jack swing. What's the man going on? We not have to run that shit, man. Make a nigga want to run downtown real quick, man. Run downtown and do some dances. Motown Philly. Oh shit, not even Philadelphia motherfuckers, I'm saying. Everybody drill, drill, kill, kill. Nigga ain't talking about no Boys the Men. These niggas talking. Music went from Boys the Men to niggas with triggers. Oh shit, man. That was just niggas with triggers, man. These niggas with, you know what I'm saying? I'm sorry, like, damn it. I know, I was not supposed to say the N-word, like, so technically what I owe, like a dollar or something, I owe myself a dollar. I guess what I would have to do is kind of give out the money to some folks. If they win, I mean, niggas with triggers, man. Yeah, man. Shit crazy, man. Niggas make a drill country song talking about killing niggas. And you know what? If it was cut, like, rednecks probably love this shit. It's probably gonna be a hit. Why wouldn't a redneck ride the street listening to I'ma kill you, nigga, I'ma kill you. That's not how the song go, but it might as well have went like that. Shit was terrible. Meanwhile, they look at it, they listen to that shit, and all they think is the whole time, just cha-ching, motherfucker. Nah, man. I'm a little off today, man. Y'all got us confused. I'll say excuse me, but we always on all week long. Doja Told You Radio, man. Vibe with us throughout the week. I'm on our Instagram, Facebook. I don't know if I'm putting this on YouTube. I might not even like, let y'all see my face when I actually talk about these niggas with triggers, because I don't want these niggas with triggers to come after me. Man, you said I can't rap, man. You said my shit off beat, nigga. Niggas with triggers will come after me and be like, damn, Doja. Fuck you, Doja Toldya. Call my shit whack. But nah, I fuck with Spinner Bands, man. I just, a couple of them songs did throw me off. I'ma actually go back and listen to it again. But I'm gonna definitely skip that song. I can't really ride with a movement that basically is just destroying. It's just so destructive. We done got cautious about life. And you boys obviously don't care. I think this light in my face is fucking killing me. So I'm gonna take a quick break, cause this light is baller blocking me, son. But before I take this break, man, let's talk about the new music that came out this week, man. Vince Staples dropped a new album. Of course, last week, shout out to Chulo Ramon. Better late than never for last week. So this week we got ESTG and 42 Doug. They dropped a new album called The Last Ones Left. 5EO Foreign is back with the Bible. B-I-B-L-E, because this damn show probably ain't the Bible. Because the Bible wasn't that offbeat, man. Nah, man, bad jokes. Bad jokes. Coily Ray dropped a new album called Trendsetter. And Benzino just can't stay out this lady business, man. Leave her alone, Benzino. I know that's your daughter, but let Coily Ray be, man. She, even though she's scheduled to sell only 11K, I'm not that bad. I listened to it a little bit. We played it earlier this week on the show. On Doja Toldya Radio. So, you know, we're going to play a little bit more of it on the show or whatever in here. Just a minute. Vince Staples, Ramona Park. Ramona Park broke my music. Is that the name of the album? Broke My Heart. Ramona Park broke my heart. And while some people might think he's talking about a place, he could be talking about a person. However he decide, that's a dope title. Very dope. And Asher Roth and Heather Gray, who cares? Beloved Misunderstood. Also, who cares? T Grizzly, half T, half a beast. And Gunplay, all bullshit aside. Now we talking. Gunplay is what I could get into. Again, I was already giving a good shout out and trying to get on the good side with the niggas with triggers. And I know I owe plenty of money because I've just been saying the N-word all show long. But Gunplay is like, in the world of this new rap that could be niggas with triggers, why can't Gunplay be
the Jay-Z of these niggas with triggers. Gunplay, then you got Waka Flocka, like the Biggie. Like, it's then you got, you know, Lil Durk, it's like the Drake of drill. Like, these dudes is making kill music, man. God bless Black Americans, man, because damn it, we got a lot to deal with. We damn sure got a lot to deal with. A lot of work to do. All right, so let's get into this gunplay, man. Fuck it. I'm gonna play two tracks off this gunplay. It's called All Bullshit Aside. And, it's legend. We'll be back. We're keeping the blunt with Damon RC at 7 o'clock. Actually, I might come in a little earlier than 7. And then we'll get into the next 7. RC say he's on the way. So we got action. We got plenty to talk about. If you would like to give us some ideas, you want to let us know what we should talk about, send me a message, man. TikTok topic ideas, or you can drop a message in the Missler box on the Missler app. You can drop a message and we'll talk about it next week. I know I always be paying attention to the chat box that much or whatever too, man. I got 5 away to do a notification with y'all missing. Shout out to Ron Love 79. Shout out to Israel 9. Shout out to TC. Hold on, run that shit back, man. Gunplay, man. It's called Animal Shelter, man. That's the name of his new label. All bullshit aside. I'm on the stove. I hit that bitch till it lock. I don't trust shit but my clock. I got them lows. I'm on the road. Bitch, you know I'm coming back with a block. Though I need me some rock. He gon' whip that shit up and then give me some drop. If it's true, Finny get popped on the spot. So I'm right out my pocket. Don't need me no clock. Let's go. Let's do it. I'm with a lock and a stop. I shoot out the whole parking lot. Little bit of money, a little sloppy top. That 40, I make that boy drop. If pay gotta spend, that boy gotta feel it. And you gotta pay to get in. I can see hate through the lens. Bitches and shots, I just dog to make some new friends. My up, up like they get fit. I'm just a killer for that fever with the monkey nuts at the bottom. Walk that on them like Jehovah's Witness. Leave a hole up in them, make them suffer in silence. Got a brick in the blender, looking like the 25th of December. Bitches and counters, we bend them. How can I help you? Working an animal shelter, still double M on the. We'll be back in about 15 minutes, man. Got the bitch jumping, bitch going banana. Same music if you want to rock with us. We gon' finish this shit if you start. Run it back to the ops, you and your passengers. DozhaToldya@gmail.com, man. To the yam and get live. 26 bands on the spot. Bitch on the block. Let go. Yeah, I got that bread through the roof. I hit your bitch in the coupe.